And welcome, everybody. Brother Dan Goodwin here, Prophecy in the News. I have in the studio with me my friend Kamal Salim. I have some brand new, well, not brand new, but I've got some DVDs from him. And I think most of our audience has possibly not met Brother Kamal. And we're going to talk about a couple of DVD sets that he has and in this week's program. So we wanted to come on just for a couple minutes. I wanted to introduce him to you. And I wanted to let you know what we're going to talk about this week. So, Brother Kamal, you and I met several years ago at Southwest Radio Church conference. I think I was speaking there and you were speaking there. And I think I met you there. And I've noticed your English is better now than it was then. You were harder to understand for me back then. You grew up in a Muslim country, right?
Muslim family, Muslim country.
In fact, it's worse than that. You were being trained for something, right?
Absolutely. You know, my childhood was not the norm like any childhood. You see, in our world, in the Islamist world, we are brought up from our childhood to play the right keys in the future, to affect the future, to affect the culture. In the Western civilization world, kids, they go to college, still have no idea what they're going to be or what curriculum they're going to go. So therefore, we've been shaped. My family, we're a Muslim Sunni family in the heart of Lebanon, Beirut, Lebanon. And my mother's teaching was amazing. That led me to what I was going to do in future years.
Now, can you share what is it you were being trained to do?
Well, the thing is, you know, in my house in Beirut, Lebanon, we have 14 brothers and sisters. We lived in a three-room house.
14 brothers and sisters.
Three-room house, a living room, bedroom, and a kitchen, and one bathroom.
If you were the youngest, you'd starve.
Well, and we have one bathroom.
Oh, my goodness.
So the terrorism started there.
You know? That's good.
So it's divide and conquer. You have to rise before sunrise. But the uniqueness in our home, the boys were taught one thing, is to be leaders, to affect the future and shape the future, and also to rule the future, while the girls were trained to be subservient, to be slave to their husband, to be, you know, the meek, and to live, to just serve her husband and be whatever he wants her to be in his making. So the making that my mother was telling me, she said, "My son, you are so pure at heart. One day you will bring the glory to Allah. Allah is the God of Islam." She said, "You will die by dying and, you know, killing Jews and Christians for his glory. And then the host of heaven will celebrate what you're going
to
do."
So you were being trained to be what we know of as a terrorist.
Well, we don't call them terrorists in Lebanon. We are liberators because, you see, yes, because in the Muslim understanding, and that is what a lot of people need to understand, they believe that the Jews and the Christians and the Muslim worship the same God. So therefore, the Jews and the Christians perverted the faith, perverted the belief, so Islam is coming to hold them to accountability.
Okay.
So therefore, our job is to really judge the Jews and the Christians.
So in a nutshell, that's it. You were being trained, and the Muslims believe that they're the true part of religion, and it's been corrupted by the Christians and the Jews, and therefore you commanded to wipe them off or overthrow them.
To bring everything to Islam,
yeah,
and establish what's so-called Ummah. U-M-M-A-H, which is one world order under Allah.
Now, already, the audience probably knows more about this issue than they ever knew before, just in 2 or 3 minutes here, because we're not hearing this stuff. You're not hearing it on even Fox News. We're not hearing this kind of information.
Yes.
And so the show this week, this is what we're going to talk about. Let me just whet your appetite here for a second here. I've got a list of things I'm going to ask this brother. And by the way, he's a born again Christian. He's no longer trying to kill us. All right.
I've been ordained for 26 years now.
All right,
I've been ordained minister.
So he's not trying to kill us anymore. So we're going to find out the difference. We're going to find out what a Muslim is and what Islam is. We're going to ask him about some things about Muhammad that we've all heard about, the 6-year-old girl that he married. We're going to talk to him about that, ask what the truth of those things are. We're going to learn about the Shiites and the Sunnis and what the differences are. These are things we don't know.
Yes,
doesn't know a lot of this stuff.
Yes.
We're going to talk about the Muslim Brotherhood. I mean, I bet you most people couldn't explain what the Muslim Brotherhood is. I'm not sure I could do a very good job at it. I'd just be guessing at it. But this thing about being radicalized, That's a new term now in the last few years, but we're going to discuss that. So that and a whole bunch more that he has on these DVDs. How long are these? Like 6 hours each?
Yeah, 6 hours. Let me have this one, please.
Yep.
This one here, this is six classes. It's two DVDs, six sessions. Each one is about an hour. And it's about, if you want to know about everything we're going to talk about and then a whole lot more. Me and General Jerry Boykin, we were talking about this. This guy was hunting people like me, and we were hunting him out.
Yeah.
But today, me and him preach the gospel of good news together.
In that sense.
And we put this together to wake up America. Because what the Muslim, the Islamist, what they did to America so far, it is severe. 9/11 happened, took place. And America hit the snooze button, went back to sleep. We still have no idea what we're dealing with because we listen to the media more than we listen to the Bible.
All right, Brother Kamal, we're glad that you come in. And folks out there, we want you to know this week's program is Brother Kamal. If we live through this, if I live through the interview with him, this week is going to be a program. We're going to talk about Muslims. We're going to talk about Islam and all these things as much as we can fit in. And we're just going to chat. You and I are going to sit here and chat.
Yes, sir.
And I'm going to try to learn some things. I have not watched every session yet. I've watched most of them on here. But I haven't watched them all yet. But we're gonna talk to you, and and of course I already knew you. We go back a little ways. We're not close friends, but you and I have been together a few times, and we've talked on the phone a few times.
That's
and cut
right.
Up too.
So. Co-laborer in Christ.
Yeah. So appreciate you, and boy, General Boykin, he's tremendous on here. Tremendous.
Yes, he is.
And he's been on our show before.
Yes.
And I'll try to get him back again. I think this is an important topic for this
Amen.
Hour.
It is. And we need to understand is it the picture is bigger than Christian Muslims. It goes into the depth of Marxism and socialism and where Islam fit in all this. You know, how they have been used to herd, being herd into this culture.
Okay. All right, folks, there you have it. So don't forget the program this week. Hey, share these YouTube videos with your social media. Share them on Facebook. Like it, you know, whatever it is. Comment underneath if you want. And let's get this out there. If you like the programs, if this is something you want, you think people ought to see, share it. Get it out there, okay? So, all right, until then, keep looking up.